of this tournament. Welcome back, Stephen.
Thank you.
Where have you been all week?
Well, trying to play snooker. I shouldn't have bothered.
You've been playing a seniors event, haven't you? Didn't go quite as well as you would have hoped.
No, it was poor. I went out in the first round to a guy called Jonathan Bagley, so it was a bit of a waste of time. So I'm back where I belong.
Good to have you back. Scunthorpe's loss is our gain. We've had a tremendous week here in Llandudno. And, of course, we saw Ronnie O'Sullivan in cracking form to beat Judd Trump last night. What have you made of Ronnie this season?
At times it's been snooker perfection. At times he's just been unplayable. And there's times, but even when he's not been at his best, players have tended to collapse. You know, players are showing him a lot of respect. Some of them are beat before they even got on the table. There's only one or two. It's no coincidence that John Higgins, who's got a little bit of a thing over Ronnie O'Sullivan, is one of the only ones that's not constantly paying compliments to Ronnie. All the other players seem to be, you can't wait to see how good he is. You know, if I was still playing, I wouldn't be giving him compliments.
Well, listen, he's on the verge of a fifth ranking title this season, something only you've done along with Ding Junhui and Mark Selby. Just how much of an achievement might that be?
Oh, phenomenal. In this era, I mean, obviously, there's more tournaments to win, so there's more tournaments on offer. But still, to dominate the way he has this season is a phenomenal achievement. And he's, on his day, he's still head and shoulders above the rest.
And, of course, you did it as a very young man. He's doing it as a 42-year-old. Mm. He's, you know, he's in the form of his life.
Yeah, very much so. And if you look at the form players this season, all the same age. You know, Mark Williams has won two tournaments plus the six Reds. John Higgins has won two events. Ronnie could win five. And there's still two or three to go this season. So it's phenomenal how well these three players and how well they're starting to dominate the game.
Yeah, you touched on Mark Williams there. He celebrated his 43rd birthday this week. He's here in Wales. He gets a wonderful reception. Mm. He's had a cracking season, hasn't he?
Yep, he's turned his game around. Obviously, he's tweaked some things technically. He's working with his sight right. And it's done wonders for his game. But what impressed me now about Mark Williams is scoring heavy, which was always lacking with his game. He's always able to scrap out frames and win the ugly frames, but he's winning frames in one visit now, which was always lacking in his game.
Well, we're going to see him in action here tonight. And earlier, he talked to Neil Foulds.
Mark, it's not even 12 months ago. You're out of the 16 and you had to qualify for the World Championships and didn't make it to the Crucible. Quite a turnaround since then. Can you quite believe how things have developed?
No, not really, because, like I said many times now, I was really thinking about packing the game in. First time ever since I've been playing, and I really was thinking about it. And look what I am, nearly 12 months on, playing some of the best stuff I've played in years.
Yeah, and I thought when you played in Germany, that's the best I've seen you play for a really long time. But against Ryan, you played at least as well as that, and he put you under a lot of pressure as well in the last round.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I went 4-0 up, didn't miss a ball, and he came back to 4-3, and he was probably looking the stronger player. But I only missed one really pot I should have got even when it was 4-3, so you know, that just shows up all the standards like these days. But the way I finished the match off was pleasing as well, because it's easy to win, you know, when you're in front and you're winning by big score lines, but when the pressure's on, it's still nice to produce a couple of breaks.
Yeah, and you came into this tournament as a number two seed on the 1 year list, and the number one seed, you know, is through to the final, so it's all on current form, and you're playing another a form player, a champion of champions winner tonight in Sean. Good record against him, 6-6, I think we've got it, very tight.
I've beat him a few times, obviously he's beat me, and I'm looking forward to it. I know he's got a bad back and pulled up with a couple of tournaments, but I got to pull that to my back of my mind, really, and just try and keep playing the way I have been for all season.
Yeah, you can only concentrate on your own game, and good luck. We're looking forward to it tonight.
Cheers, Neil.
Yeah, we certainly are. We've moved back up into the studio, joined by Neil Foulds, Alan McManus. Interesting to hear him talk there, Mark Williams. Very relaxed. I mean, he is one of the coolest customers on the tour, isn't he?
Yeah, and I should think someone who's been twice world champion, losing to Stuart Carrington last year, not to get to the Crucible, that happened once before. That would be a really low moment for him because he's so used to playing there. So it is an incredible turnaround. He's, you know, in the top, firmly in the top eight with all these points on the 1 year list. You know, he's back for good now. And at the moment, you know, he could be the man if someone's going to beat Ronnie O'Sullivan. Well, he's not been tested against him lately. He could be the man if he wins tonight.
Interesting also to hear Malin say that, you know, 12 months ago he was almost thinking about packing in the game. Mm. How can you have turned it around so dramatically?
Just a change in technique. It's as simple as that. It's given him a new hunger to actually play the game in practice. I think when you're out of form and having a period of time when you've been such a champion that Mark has been down the last couple of decades, you, when you're losing to guys that you shouldn't be losing against, you lose a bit of heart as well. So it's given him a new thing where he can go in the club every day. Didn't want to play many shots like that today, but he's been going in, practicing and having something to work on, something that he's now seen the benefit of the hard work. And, he's playing as well as ever, there's no question.
What do you see, Stephen, in his game that's changed?
Well, as I said when we were out at the table, he's scoring. You can put fear into opponents, you know, by winning for scrappy frames, but nothing puts the fear into opponent like if you win a frame in one visit. And that's what he's started to do. That's what he's introduced to his game the last few months. Funny enough, I spoke to him a couple of years ago at the UK and he'd lost, and he said, look, I don't care. He says, I'm happy with my life. I just, you know, if I win, I win. If I lose, I lose. You know, I'm not bothered with getting beaten in the quarter final. I said, you're a liar. You know, you want to be winning, surely. And now he's got that. He looks like he wants to win now. He's got that his mojo back, if you like.
He was very good against Yan Bingtao, but that match against Ryan Day when he scored,
yes,
amazingly well, and those incredible first four frames. If it hadn't come to the interval, he'd have beat him 6-0.
Yeah, he was 4-0 up and he played almost perfect snooker to do so. And then Ryan Day, on the back of two tournament wins in successive weeks, you know, was roaring back at him. This is what he did early on. He dominated, you know. And it's almost like he knew he had to raise his game. He's friends with Ryan. They're Welsh teammates in the World Cup. But he's almost as if saying, now I've got to play as I have been to beat him. And when it got back a little bit tight, and I think we are going to see it shortly, he's still, when he's chipping away to go 4-0 up. But when he got to 4-3, he'd been a long time without potting a ball, and he makes 141 total clearance, you know, the mark of a true... This is it.
Yeah, this long red that I spoke to him about this in the practice room actually this morning. The difference is he played it and fancied it. And if I get a chance to commentate later on tonight, I think I'm going to explain to the viewers a little bit about this technique, because I asked him about it, and it's, as I said before, it's simplified his thought process. Every shot is now simple, where things were complicated in his mind for probably 5 years, and that was where he was losing heart, but no more.
His cue ball control is just so much better in the last season, and it's shown in the century breaks. I think you said, Alan, he's made 36 centuries this season, and that's what he needs to compete and start winning tournaments again. Mm. You're not going to win tournaments winning scrappy frames all the time. You've got to keep winning frames in one visit.
Mm. Well, let's have a think about his opponent, of course, Sean Murphy, the magician. He's been struggling all week. He's been struggling the last few weeks, of course, with this injury in his neck. He's had some treatment, but he's won a couple of matches here to get him into a semi-final.
Yeah, I mean, the two tournaments that Ryan won, he didn't get to play, and he doesn't miss tournaments very much. But Mark Williams is right about one thing. He's got to just ignore all this. I mean, we're seeing the full works here he's giving it, isn't he? And no doubt he's not feeling great.
I was going to say, I'm surprised he's not maybe asked to be allowed to take the bow tie off, because that's very restrictive, especially if you're stiff getting down at the table.
I don't think Sean would do that. He's too respectful for the game. Yeah. No bow tie. Pull out of this one as well.
If you're just looking at him there, his head position when he's down, it's kind of like that, and he's trying to look up. And that's not good. You want to be facing the shot, and he can't quite do that. So he's straining when he's down there. It's not easy.
So how do you think he'll manage against Mark Williams then? But I mean, they've got a great head-to-head. They've played each other many times, 6 apiece. Mm.
Well, in some ways, it simplifies it for him, the actual game, because he's protecting that injury out there. We don't want to labour the point, but I think he's got to go out and just... I think the problem is the first two matches, it seems to get worse and worse as the match goes on. Hopefully that won't be the case tonight, but he needs to get a frame in the board early, I think.
It's going to be absolutely fascinating. After the break, we will see if the man they call the magician can pull a rabbit out of the hat. Murphy beat Williams on the way to winning the Gibraltar Open last season, but Williams avenged that defeat on his way to the final of the China Open a few weeks later. Stephen Hendry is alongside Phil Yates in the commentary box, and out in the middle to get proceedings underway, our MC, John McDonald.
Hello and a very warm welcome. You've joined us live from the venue Cymru here in Llandudno. Welcome along to the semi-final stages of the Ladbrokes Players' Championship. It's brought to you by World Snooker. We are live on ITV Sport as we welcome the millions of viewers joining us around the world. Well, our referee, Robert Zlaboski, is ready to go. It's time now to meet our players. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome a winner of the Elite Triple Crown, the 2005 Champion of the World, the magician, Sean Murphy! ladies and gentlemen, it's time to meet a Welsh legend. With 20 ranking events, he is the former two-time champion of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the Prince and Pride of Wales, Mark
Williams. What a reception that was, and fully justified. Mark Williams is playing some of the snooker of his life. He's up against this evening the man they call the magician.
Thank you. The first frame, Mark Williams to break.
But I'll tell you what, Williams has got plenty of tricks up his sleeve as well. One to savour.
Fluke, obviously. Every player's playing to get the cue ball tight in that bolt cushion. But Mark Williams must just be absolutely loving life at the moment. As we mentioned in the studio last year, thinking about quitting the game now. One of the favourites for every event we're playing in now.
Foul and miss. Mark Williams, four.
The referee is from Poland, Robert Zablocki. And without any shadow of doubt, the most important match that he's ever taken charge of.
Foul and miss. Mark Williams, four.
Cue ball put back. Sean Murphy, as I said, known as the magician. I think at times this week, with all of his back and neck ailments, he must have felt as though he'd been sawn in half. But a half-fit Murphy has beaten Kyron Wilson and Anthony McGill, so do not underestimate him.
Yeah, I think the fact that he's come through, especially that 6-5 in the second round, proves that he's fit enough to play to a very high standard. In terms of long potting and scoring, it's very difficult to separate these two. If anything, if frames go scrappy, you would have to favour Williams to win the majority of those frames. Very clever. Big pressure on Williams tonight. In this event, getting to a major final in Wales. Expectation from the crowd and on himself. That's obviously comes part and parcel with playing well and competing in tournaments regularly at the business end. Your expectation levels increase dramatically.
Murphy special with position attached.
What?
first seven. Two meetings between these two actually occurred on Welsh soil in the Welsh Open. 2006-2008. Murphy won both matches 5-2. Eight. Making a total of three centuries.
Now, he may choose to go in the red to the right of the pink. He may choose to go into that red at pace. Pink and black out of commission. Okay, there was only one red to 13. Play for, really, and he's on it nicely enough. He's got just an awkward angle. This needs to be struck very well to get back for the blue. And it was struck beautifully. Okay, he's lost position, but excellent cueing.
14.
A bit surprised he didn't go into the reds from that previous blue. You can see, not straightforward to get nicely in a red. And in a way, to carry on the break. Going into that red beside the pink from that blue would have certainly brought the pink into play.
Brown ball.
Well, he's chosen to go into the reds from that brown, which was, you know, I'm sure,
18.
You can see a far more difficult way of doing it than from that perfect angle he had in the blue previously.
Now,
the red to right middle. Does he have an angle just to nudge the red away from the pink? Leave the pink to left corner. No, he does. And now this is
25.
A very good chance to win the opening frame.
And if he can win it in a single visit, it's the ideal way to stamp your authority. Knocking a red from distance. Do the rest from there.
Thirty-two. Thirty-nine.
In spite of having to pull out of the last couple of events, as we've talked about, it's been a really solid season for Sean Murphy. By reaching this semi-final, he's taken his total prize money for the campaign over $400,000.
Forty-five.
Well, he's okay. He's got a choice of two reds, but none of them are the ones that he played for.
46.
He looks to have a decent 52. Angle in this red, just to chip the red away. That's to the left of the black. Leave the black to the same pocket. Very impressive start this, Sean Murphy.
60.
Looks very focused around the table. 61. The ball.
61.
So well. One of those players that he cues the ball so well that it's quite intimidating when you're sat 68. In your chair watching this.
Williams Powerless as Murphy takes on frame ball.
Yeah, Mark looked really intimidated there, didn't he?
69.
Last shot.
That, Stephen, has been the great joy of this tournament.
75.
Every single match has been quality through and through.
76.
Well, as you would expect from the calibre of player that you have here. It's their job, is to come to events like this and play top snooker.
82.
Fantastic lineup, especially the semi-final lineup. It's incredible.
90. Yes, normally at this stage we'd start talking about, well, one of them could qualify for the Champion of Champions come November, but that's not an issue now because all three players left in the event are already well and truly qualified. So one
91.
Less morsel of pressure to deal with.
Brilliant start from Sean Murphy. Started this break off with a trademark long shot, long red to right corner. It wasn't easy to start this break the way the reds were situated, but
108.
Once he cannoned that red away from the pink, it's been inevitable.
Hundred and twenty. 126.
130. Clean, efficient, and flawless. For his very first trick, the magician pulls a rabbit from the hat. What a way to take a
Sean Murphy to break.
Welcome back to Venue Cymru for frame two of a possible 11. And this is the second semi-final of the Ladbrokes Players' Championship. Ronnie O'Sullivan has got his feet up metaphorically today, waiting for the winner of this. And I'm sure he'll be impressed if he watched the first frame, because Murphy played it beautifully. To such an extent, actually, that when the final ball went in, one of those clapping was Mark Williams.
Yeah.
Beautiful shot.
One.
Can Mark Wilms reply in kind with his own one visit win in this frame? Okay, very early to say something like that, but at this standard, you got to look at these chances, these opportunities to win the frames.
Eight. Nine.
I know the match is in the embryonic stage, Stephen, but you can't get better than 100% both of them.
Chance to go into their bunch and leave a red. Ooh. Just, I think if Sean Murphy had played 16. That shot, he would have played it with a lot more power. Just to get a bit more action on the cue ball. A bit tentative for me, that shot.
43, Mark. Can't expend the physical energy to get down the 22. Shot properly.
A red, two down from the pink pot to the right corner.
31.
Also the red that's to the left of the bunch, the left hand side of the table, obviously pots to either right middle or left corner. So he's got options.
38.
Didn't get to that one. Okay, still on this black. You can play it in such a way that you'll have that red that's to the left of the table to the left corner. If he misses the black will stay over the corner pocket and cover it. But right in the middle of the pocket. But look at the cue ball. It's got a tester now.
46.
He's one of the best probably there's ever been at floating balls in. This could be a speciality here. Drop this red, dead weight. Cue ball off the cushion for the black.
47.
Lovely shot.
47.
Has he got a gap between
54.
The five reds and the two reds to play for black to the same pocket, just stun the cue ball through that gap.
Sean Murphy's not got a very good view of this shot where the referee's standing. I'm going to watch the telly. I don't know if he 55. Played the cannon on the two reds. Oh, he's lost a cue ball slightly. He'll still take this black on, but this is a dangerous shot. When I concentrate in the pot, the cue ball's going into the bunch. Well, in fact, he was straight enough in the black to avoid the pack. Has he gone far enough?
62.
Let's check out the body language.
Don't think he has. Definitely not. He's actually fully snookered on all but one of the reds, and the one red he can see, it's only a tiny amount. If that. Anywhere but there for the cue ball.
Yeah, again, you know, the different players play different shots. I think if Sean Murphy had that black off his spot, he'd have been playing a cannon into the five reds. Sullivan the same. Mark, he just loves to drop balls in, and he was quite happy to leave himself a long distance red. And this is dangerous.
Foul and miss. Mark Williams 62, Sean Murphy 6.
Well, this red goes at the bottom of the five reds to the right corner. Well, he's not. He would have been down playing it by now. I was about to say, a bit of a new favourite for the frame. So I was going to say, I don't know if he can squeeze it with a bit of left-hand side, but putting the cue ball back.
Also, trailing by 56 points, it was important for Murphy to actually get the ping back in the middle of the table. It took a while to decide, but I always thought the white was going to be returned to its original position. An early test, this for Robert Zablocki, working in tandem with the marker, of course, and video capture. It's actually the kind of shot here where a millimetre makes a massive difference. He needs to be very precise where he puts the pink and the cue ball in relation to each other. I think he's done a pretty good job, indeed he has.
Yeah, it's all right.
Well, look for positives there. The only one is that he's knocked the black onto the cushion. Apart from that, it was potentially very costly. Clearly that was a struggle, painful, to reach over the table like that.
Seven.
I know, Stephen, you won a tournament in New Zealand once with damaged ankles. I remember that one, but did you ever play with a bad back?
No, it's one thing that never troubled me at all in my career. A bit unlucky not to have something more simple than this. He played the split beautifully.
Eight.
No problem. Oh, he's 48 points behind. It's hard to make a case for Sean Murphy not being favourite now for this frame. Now this red to left corner. I'd be tempted, if the black goes to right corner, I'd be tempted to play for it. Because he doesn't have to play the pot at any pace, and he's guaranteed to be on the other red to the right corner. A little bit surprised. Okay, the black's missable. But if he could, the angle he had already could be right behind the black. Could play a dead weight.
Eighteen.
So could we be in for the first psychological 19. Blow of the semi-final.
Twenty-six.
Sean has looked at the scoreboard two or three times in this break, but he's got plenty of points to play with.
Nine.
Just a little bit awkward, this positional shot. Just going to avoid the cannon on the red. And in doing so, I'm going to leave that cue ball close to the right-hand side cushion. If you were playing for the pink to the same pocket, normally you'd stun off two cushions, and the point where you'd hit the black cushion would be almost exactly where that other red is. That's why he's taking his time over this shot. 30 to play playing ball. The ball was always going to be going over to that right-hand side of the table. So you think this is a shot in this frame to get nicely on this red, and he is.
36.
I don't know what he played there. It's almost as if he just made sure of the red. Surely he had to go up for the blue or the pink to the left corner. He's left himself a tough shot here to get nicely on the yellow.
Well, he's arrived on the colours 13 behind, 43. Which means he will need the awkward black.
Four
from five. Yeah.
There's not many players in the game that I'd have to put one of those shots for me. Long shot, stunning. Round off two cushions. Again.
48.
A strange shot. Come in and out of bulk. A choice of screwing it off one cushion or playing off three cushions. He's making hard work of this.
52.
Yes, more adventurous than accurate with the cue ball. But it's still going. And two pots away now from inflicting a massive blow. Crushing.
No, he had a chance to win this black arrow on the frame.
63.
Get out of the way. Is it going to cost him? I'm going to play it now. A lot more pressure on this now. Brilliant.
Wasn't it just? Wasn't it a brilliant break from Sean Murphy? Williams made the early running with 62. A little unluckily snookered himself. And when Murphy got the chance, cleared up. 2-0 to the 2005 world champion.
Thank you, third frame. Mark Williams to break.
Mark Williams breaking off in the third frame in something of a hole. The first frame was dominated. The second frame, well and truly stolen. But the same player did both things, Sean Murphy.
Yeah, tough school so far. Mark Williams made 62, got a position. Misplayed a swerve shot and it cost him the frame.
And that, the red we've just seen there, is the first pot that's been missed by either in the match. So Williams has a 100% pot success rate and he's 2-0 adrift. As you say, tough school. Well, he sorted out a four-ball plant in the decisive frame against Ryan Day in the quarter-final, so a plain old two-baller. Easy peasy.
Eight. Nine.
Just play a little cannon on the left-hand side of those two reds. Leave one to the right corner. Didn't get the thick enough contact on the cannon.
16.
It's amazing. Just a slight fraction.
Mark Williams, 16.
Missing that cannon or not playing the cannon correctly. lost a cue ball. And it looked a decent opportunity. He's only made 16. And you could say a good part of the reason for missing that red is what Sean Murphy has done to him in the first two frames.
He's often scored heavily against Mark Williams in their meetings, has Sean Murphy. His century in the first frame tonight was his 11th century against Williams over the years.
12.
Nicely played.
Twenty-seven. Thirty-five.
36. Lots of top spin, cued superbly well. You've seen the action on the cue ball once it made contact with the bunch. Watch the cue ball accelerate here. You're always trusting to a bit of luck with those shots. There's pressure on this pink.
Not quite 100% sure whether this will go. The pink is just in front of the red, but from the side angle, it looks really tight. No problem.
Forty-three.
We should not be surprised with this because Sean Murphy's had a really good campaign, particularly in the first half. Runner-up in the China Championship in Guangzhou. Runner-up in the Paul 45. Hunter Classic in Germany. Runner-up in the UK Championship as well. And as he struggles that one in.
46.
The highlight of the season to date. Winning the champion of champions, overcoming Ronnie O'Sullivan in the final.
42. Yeah, we're only into the third frame, but this is as impressive
52.
A display as I've seen from Sean Murphy. His whole demeanour and focus around 53. The table looks 100% bang on tonight. Doesn't look like missing.
entirely 59. Likely that Mark Williams will miss one ball and be 3-0 down.
He needs one more red to secure this third frame. He's had a look at this, the left-hand side of those two to the left corner. That's perfect.
He's
been around far too many years to take anything for granted, but Sean Murphy will be absolutely delighted with the way he started this match. Textbook. Two big breaks and a big clearance.
82.
Now targeting century number 35 of the season.
90.
One of snooker's great ambassadors is totally governing this match. Another tremendous effort, this time 117. Murphy, 3-0.
Thank you. Fourth frame. Sean Murphy to break.
Sean Murphy could not have wished for anything better. What an intro to the contest. And you have to say, Mark Williams reeling. He won't be panicking just yet, but he's reeling.
This red in between the black and the bunch is potable to the right corner, but it's fraught with danger. This, he can just stun the cue ball, leave it where the red is. Shot to nothing. Well, I have to play so full of confidence.
Let's
see how aggressive he is with this black. Blind pocket. So easy to take your eye off the pot and concentrate on the cue ball here. Well, this is so impressive.
Eight.
Queuing from under the cushion, never easy, but now even though he's not yet in double figures, you have to say the way he's playing, frame-winning opportunity, and I don't normally say that so early.
Yeah, but when one of the best players in the world is in this form, you'd be absolutely 14. Shocked if he didn't win the frame at this visit. Because you just get into these runs. The zone, as it's called in sport.
15.
See, something that's normally associated with being in a zone is the mouth is just ever so slightly open.
22.
Just a relaxed way.
38.
You've seen a slight grimace from Sean there. 3 inches short with a cue ball. That's the only thing when you're playing this well you have to guard against is just that carelessness. And just taking things for granted.
99 balls potted this, the 100th. Out of 101. What a strike rate, although that shot.
44.
Has become a little misjudged.
Yeah, no, caused by that shot. Two balls ago from the black, the careless positional shot has got him into this trouble. Is that red to get out of the way?
45.
Is he taking on? Can he just get through to the cue ball to play the blue to far left corner? 45. It's amazing. Just a little simple positional shot off the black. A little bit careless. And that's caused him to end this break.
1.
And Williams knows that if he can possibly salvage this frame, it would plant a seed of doubt that might well germinate in that mid-session interval.
8.
Yeah, with that red, your raised hand is there. That side cushion, you couldn't call this a great chance yet, but you can certainly get right back into the frame. 9. He's lining it up now to the left corner. So a couple of looks at it. 9. Ideally, I'd like to be a touch low, so
16.
Just sort of nudge the other two reds into the open.
17.
Not sure about that shot.
24.
Comfortable two reds on the left-hand side, the table to play for. He's got a tester now. And didn't hit that with really any conviction.
Mark Williams, 24.
Always a danger in that shot if you catch one of the reds full ball.
Murphy stretching in discomfort. But that's atomic.
Yeah, I think if you had major problems, you see him grimacing a little bit there. You cannot stretch for that shot. Surely, now he's going to take a 4-0 lead into the interval.
And very much a case of role reversal, because Williams led Ryan Day 4-0 in the quarterfinals. Just looking at the scoreboard, red black would give him a 44 point lead with 43 on. So it's going to be, well, I was about to say another gimme with the rest for Murphy, and he was miles away.
Sean Murphy, 15.
Well, that is a rare thing. And I think Sean Murphy's the best in the world, playing with the rest. Nice angle in the brown to take that red away from the right-hand side cushion. Lovely. Well played.
Six.
Oh, as well as Murphy played to go 3-0. If Mark Williams was to pinch this frame, it'd be touch and go who would feel the best going into the interval. Murphy missing that very easy red for the rest.
14.
Yes, and also on 45, you could make a case out that maybe in such command he might well have played safe. But the red with the rest, that really, as Stephen said, was the big surprise, given how well he uses that implement
16.
Day in, day out. Williams 20 behind, so he needs all the colours.
Twenty-five.
So this is the last tricky shot, you would think. Get perfectly on the pink. Is he going to come far enough?
30.
Four cushions. The black to the right corner. Perfect. He'll be delighted, Mark Williams, to win this fourth frame after the way Sean Murphy played in the first three.
36.
Snatch and grab. Not quite daylight robbery, but I'll tell you what, here in London now, Mark Williams going to the interval feeling a whole lot better. Murphy should have led 4-0. No ifs, buts or maybes. In fact, the scoreline reads 3-1.
Been some magic from Sean Murphy tonight. What a match we've got in our hands here, guys. Stephen, you've come in from commentary. Just how much did you enjoy those opening four frames?
Well, I said in commentary, the first three were as good as I've seen Sean play in terms of his whole demeanour, his whole focus, his whole the way he went about it. The second frame would probably give him more pleasure than the two centuries, the way he pinched that. But when you're playing that well and you're in that much of a groove, when all of a sudden something knocks you out, like he played a careless positional shot, sometimes it's hard to get back into that groove quickly and you missed, played a couple of bad shots.
Yeah, real entertaining opening four frames. High standard of snooker here. When you look at the stats, you know.
You know, I think sometimes we do Sean a disservice, myself included, when we say he's not as good a safety player as the rest of the guys, and it's easy to forget sometimes just how good a player he is. He showed the first four frames there how good it can be. It was simply awesome.
Neil, you were keeping an eagle eye on this one. You've picked out some shots, you know, plenty to pick from.
Yeah, Alan and I will look through that. You know, I think it's tremendous snooker, and we're going to see the first frame now. And he started so well, Sean, here, because this is Mark, as Alan pointed out. You know, he's playing the swinging the cue ball around the angle safety shot, which he didn't play badly, but he's left a long red to the right corner here.
Yeah, myself and Neil were taught this is a quintessential modern day frame. Mark plays a good safety shot. You're thinking, oh, Sean might be in a bit of trouble early doors here. 133 points later, following that long red.
Yeah, I mean,
and he was off and running.
Yeah, I mean, I think Mark said something very important before the match when I spoke to him. Here's the cannon he played. He said, I've got to put out of my mind this business about him having a bad neck, because I tell you what, if he's got a bad neck, then a few other players will be wanting one, because he's playing brilliantly, you know. And this, as Stephen said, I mean, I think in this game here, I mean, he got in behind the pink here, which I'm amazed he finished there.
Yeah, and he is, but the cue ball's come off the cushion enough for it to be a comfortable shot to go into to use the reds as a stopper. I think a lot of players would have played into the bunch here.
Especially being a lefty, it's comfy bridging for a lefty, that, isn't it?
Yeah, but we all know Mark Williams, he just loves to just drop balls in dead weight and just, you know, possibly the fact he knows he's 6-2 ahead from putting that black, he doesn't need to go into the bunch, maybe that was in the back of his mind. But I think a Murphy or a Sullivan would have gone into the bunch there.
I think he miscalculated, or certainly he missed a trick in playing low-value colours where he needed the black at the end, but in the end he took them. I mean, this is as good as the ping, you know, he drills this in the middle. He's got so much confidence. But there's always the worry that he's got to pop the black down the cushion because he didn't take enough value colours in dishing up. But in it goes. And I think what happens is, you know, these frames hurt more than the ones where someone makes a century against you. And here's another, this is great cueing. You picked out some shots here, Alan.
Yeah, we loved a couple of blacks in the spin here. Two shot, two colours in a row, actually. He hits these ever so well. They're going in the middle of the pocket, and then he's got there was a couple of nice pinks. This was a big pressure shot after the reds opened. Just wriggled it in, and then another one with nice control. Someone beautifully.
Someone sent me a tweet, actually, said that one, the first pink where the red was next to it, he thought it was hitting them both at the same time, which, of course, if it was simultaneous, it would be a foul. But I don't think it was. I think the general feeling is, you know, it was pink first,
yeah,
and he had enough room to go through, and it was a brilliant break.
Steamed into that 3-0 lead. Just how important do you think, in context of this match, was the fourth frame?
Oh, huge. Huge. I mean, Mark Williams would be delighted. He's 3-1 down, but he'll be absolutely delighted being 3-1 down. Sean Murphy's completely dominated it. And yeah, as I say, it's really fractions. We're seeing, when you see Mark Williams, he played a couple of nice cannons. But I go back to the Sean Murphy. He was in complete control, 2 inches out with a positional shot in the black. All of a sudden, he's out of position. And he's let Mark Williams back into this match.
He pushed those beyond the middle bag. I mean, obviously, he came too far here, but this is a shot. If you shape it right, Alan, you're going to be right in behind the black. He didn't want to be there, but it looked nice.
He's the only player in the world that drops this in dead weight, isn't he?
I know. Stephen came in and he said, first thing he says is, why is he dropping that black? And everyone else would punch it in. But, you know, I said last night, the higher the standard the snooker, the smaller the margins between success and failure.
Four, absolutely. Brilliant frames of snooker, really enjoyable, and the ones that hurt, the ones that you lose, that you should win, you know.
Yeah, 93%, 97% pot success rate for both of these
great
players. High quality snooker. We can't wait to get it back underway. Hugely entertaining, as I said. We'll bring you the conclusion of Mark Williams against Sean Murphy in just a couple of minutes. To miss any of the action here, Mark Williams has pulled a frame back and trails Sean Murphy by 3-1 in the early exchanges of our second semi-final here at the Players' Championship. Bringing us the conclusion of the match, Alan McManus is alongside Clive Everton in the commentary box. And first to reintroduce the players, our MC, John McDonald.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome back our semi-finalist, Sean Murphy and Mark Williams.
Sean Murphy played like Superman in the first three frames.
You.
133
Thank
total
you.
Clearance, 70 clearance
35.
To win on the black.
Mark Williams to break.
Clearance of 117, 3-0. And he also put Williams 45-0 down in the fourth. But then he started to show that he was fallible after all, made a couple of mistakes, and Williams eventually cleared with 43 to win on the black. So it's 3-1 to Murphy instead of the 4-0, which looked likely midway through the fourth frame. To what extent will the interval affect Murphy's brilliant form? The interval often does change the course of a match. Sometimes it doesn't. Williams has actually played pretty well this evening when he's had the chance. In the second frame, for instance, he made 62 very nicely, then ran out of position and lost the frame to Murphy's 70 clearance.
Eight.
And there, using extreme pace, he arced the cue ball right round the bunch.
Yeah, it's funny, I was saying in the studio that Mark Williams, the last shot of the first session, rolling the black, and he's, Stephen mentioned a few times, more comfortable rolling balls. He's not a power player. Not all that comfortable playing that type of shot.
Mark Williams, 8.
Strictly from a neutral point of view, I was pleased to see Mark win that fourth frame. You want to see a
Good hard-fought, close contest. Second semi-final. See if he can just avoid the brown playing this. Expect the cue ball close to it. Yeah, didn't quite get it. Right hand side as intended. Right half of the table.
Well, one thing that Williams doesn't want to do is leave the right-hand red to right corner, because Murphy's long potting has been deadly. Therefore, he carefully keeps the cue ball over the left-hand side of the table.
The only thing now in playing it, it probably won't be a path back to balk should Sean leave it, that red you're talking about, Clive. So he can play the green half of the table with a wee bit more confidence. Good shot that. Well thought out. And you see around it below the black spot area is congested, so it's much of a problem for Sean playing the safety shot.
Williams has enjoyed an amazing resurgence this season. This time last year, he didn't even qualify for the World Championship. But in this campaign, he's reached six ranking quarterfinals or better, converting two of them into titles. The Northern Ireland Open. And the German Masters. In fact, those were his first two ranking titles since the 2011 German Masters. Trapped over the congested side of the table here.
So far thinking time, but can't blame him. Part of that thinking time, the reason behind it is the form of Sean Murphy, his opponent. You see, rightly, Clive, the congestion down there may actually help him in the end. He wants to leave the cue ball near this right corner. He's going to have a chance of not leaving anything with the cover down there. Red actually nearest the cue ball. Well, is he looking at a pot? I think he is. I think he's decided that there's nothing doing safety wise. He's having a go at the red, the thin one.
Couldn't have hit it any thinner. The red hardly moved.
he won't be massively disappointed. Sean, come around just to see if this black will go. Every chance that the white will finish around that black spot area below it. I just lost it a tad. Played it well, actually. Good shot, but we got unlucky.
Black's the only colour he can hit, so he's got to be very mindful of the red nearest the left corner, which he won't want to leave for Williams.
Calculated risk, trying to use green and blue as a blocker. And then settle for that.
For a multi one.
Well, Murphy is sometimes critical of the quality of his own safety play, but that was really good. Williams has got a similar problem. He wants to keep Murphy away from the red nearest the black. Appears to have done so, courtesy of the blue.
Yeah, it's almost like a little mini game of chess going on out there in that red over left corner. Now he's tracking in behind green and brown. Got it a wee bit thick, but the blacks came to his rescue. That one hand was bad for Mark Williams, but at least he can't leave a red now. Can he slip in behind the bulk colours?
Has got Murphy over the awkward side of the table. Was he examining the possibility there of red going in off the black via the side cushion?
One of those reds, the four in a line, is the bottom one, does it go? Well, probably doesn't actually. And even if it did, it would be dangerous playing it as a pot. I don't think it quite goes. You're looking at that and off that you're talking about, Clive. You certainly get the cue ball back into the bulk area, but that other red would probably stick there.
Ultra thin contact required. Very good shot.
Sean's now coming round to look at the red. Actually, I think the four in the line, the second nearest the black spot, he may well be playing that one, because that one will definitely pass. There it is.
What a great long potter Murphy is.
One.
Yeah, going to trust the luck here with a kiss. Can't really judge this. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do very nicely, thank you very much. If the black goes,
eight.
Even better news. I'm around to check it. This is where the Sean Murphy cue action comes in handy, because a little safety battle goes on. It's always difficult to slip into scoring mode, but the flowing cue action definitely helps him.
Murphy missed the last two tournaments in Gibraltar and Bucharest through neck and shoulder problems, from which he was still suffering when he arrived here in Llandudno. But you'd never think it, the way he's playing now.
33.
He doesn't want to play the cannon into the bunch. He's almost guaranteed to be on one playing it. He just potted that a wee bit in the thick side, so the cue ball didn't get as high as he'd hoped. And dropping it in is not really any good, so probably forced to play the cannon. But doing the right thing, giving himself a few extra seconds, play this. Well, he is dropping it. Feels he can hold for a red.
Fort.
The way he's playing, I'd be very surprised 48. If he didn't clinch the frame at this visit.
49 56 57
Always tries to be very active around the table, Sean Murphy, kind of stomping walk that he's got.
64.
65. Kind of bouncing around the table, just trying to feel positive all the time. Part of his makeup.
72 73
Well over the winning line with a 98% pot success rate. He's only missed three in the entire match.
79 8
And now in hot pursuit of his third century of the match. 133 in the opening frame and 117 in the third.
88
Well,
Sean Murphy,
slightly careless, but with a break at 88, Sean Murphy extends his lead to 4-1.
Thank you, frame six. Sean Murphy to break.
Now, Mark Williams isn't 4-1 behind because he's playing badly. He's actually playing pretty well, but Murphy is playing so superbly that he's giving him few clear-cut opportunities. No attempt at the pot there. Had he tried the half-court packet and missed it, he would have left the red between blue and middle pocket for sure.
safety, has to get this, absolutely has to get it in the thin side. I'd be surprised if he missed it. Good shot. Slip past the yellow. The upper hand here, not quite, just slowed up on him. It's quite a big target now in behind the bulk cars, the colours, the shot that Sean's playing. Fancy him. Yeah, it was the only way he couldn't. Cannon the brown, he got unfortunate that. I have to say though, obviously Sean Murphy's been tip-top scoring form so far, but as far as the safety battle, we always weigh up, don't we, with these top players. I think Sean's got Mark chasing his tail a wee bit so far. And here's another good one. Definitely got the slight upper hand so far in that department. Against a Sean Murphy, it's not just that your safety execution has to be good, it's got to be smart as well. You can't leave him too many sticking out. You go back to the very start of the match, they're ready potted, and they made 1-3-3 off it. And Mark Williams would have been going back to his chair on that occasion thinking, OK, pal, have a go at that one. And he sat in his chair for about 10 minutes.
Foul and miss. Mark Williams, four.
That safety had to be ultra thin.
A sign of Mark's confidence here playing this. Yeah. Not easy, whichever ready plays.
Well, it was a tough shot there. Not just the pot, but avoiding other balls. Hasn't left an easy starter though.
Yeah, you almost feel that when your opponent has a go at a red, misses it and can't catches one down this end, you almost feel entitled to have a go at something. Sometimes it's difficult to refuse. Think in the end, it's the red that's the one that's below the pink spot. That's the one that he has to not leave Mark Williams in playing this to the far corner. So he'd need to bring the cue ball back, almost not behind the black, but just to the left of it. Leave the pink in the middle. Just wants a wee bit of grab here. Just the cue, bring the cue ball back 3 or 4 inches. claws on that pink, but that was queuing of the highest order.
Seven.
Highest spot available for the pink is the brown.
Eight.
This is important now, and it's not that difficult, but it's important that he lands straight in this next red. He wants just off straight in the next blue. But he gets that red that's on the pink spot out the way here. He could be in 13. Business. Is he straight enough on the blue
14.
To be able to hold for it? Can certainly play for it in the left middle. 5 or 6 inches.
19.
Pace out the cue ball. The one in the pink spot's the one he wanted to play. He'll probably play for the blue in playing it. Right. You're playing the other one. Oh, he's lifting the red anyway. Very clever.
20. Yeah.
The best shot he could have played.
There's no doubt in my mind that when he plays with the rest, it's the most uncomfortable shot for him.
27.
He can't get down low on it. He's got to hang off it a wee bit, and not getting down and getting full leverage on his delivery with the rest.
The red that he was after was the one almost on the black spot to the right of it. And he pulls out a fine recovery shot.
28.
This is actually a nice shot in the brown, plain ball, cue ball, in between blue and black. He's got three reds he can land on. Make that two this time. Cue ball's going to be in a similar position, so must get south of the black here for the cue ball. Yeah, clever. That's why he rolled it in. Guaranteed being on one.
38.
Williams must be fearing that this is 5-1 coming up. 5-1. So how relieved must he be that Murphy overcut that black 39. To middle?
Again, blind pocket. He's probably got the cannon in his mind as well. If he just had to pot that without playing a cannon, it would have been a wee bit easier.
just possible that we may have seen a turning point.
Eight.
If Murphy had exploited the full potential of that
nine
break-making position, it would have been 5-1 and couldn't have seen him losing from there.
Now is it Mark Williams' turn to be the burglar?
16.
I don't want to push this red too close to the left side cushion. Good shot that, he just held it there.
24, 25, 32.
It's not a massive problem here. He can play for the black in the opposite corner. He just wants to be careful of the red that he's going to cannon. I don't want to push it too close to that bottom cushion. As I say, it's not a huge problem. It's just that the red's... He's just trying to grab this and play for it in the same pocket.
33.
Don't know what he's done to his hand.
Sometimes on a little awkward shot like that, you can almost put a little bone in your finger out of place because you're in a kind of unconventional kind of shot. Anyway, that's important. I think you want to finish high, left of straight as we see this. Well, no, he's not, so he's straight, so it's going to have to utilise a blue here, blue or bulk colour. 40.
Seems to have broken the skin on his little finger. Black not readily available from the left-hand side of the table. And this is straight red, as good as.
He might be able to get the yellow with a little mini button at the end of his cue. I don't think so, though. I think it's just too big a stretch. Trouble is, I'm not so sure if he could finish straight or low of straight in the red and playing this, yeah.
43.
So out of position, but with this 43 break, he has at least gone into the lead.
And we have our first frame tonight, the type of frame that Stephen was talking about, where we would put Mark Williams, marginal favourite. Just whether it'll pan out that way is another matter, but I agree with Stephen, Mark would be. If you put your money on someone to win this frame, it would be the Welshman. Sean, as I said, he's been very good in the safety side of things tonight.
His safety was a perfect length. Williams almost knocked the red in, but has been unlucky enough to leave an absolute sitter. The outcome of the frame is probably going to depend on the remaining red.
Yes, and the black helps him.
One.
It helps him bundle, see if he can land straight on this red.
Overcut, and I think it was
Sean
overcut
Murphy
because
six.
Murphy really didn't want to finish straight on the black. He knew he'd got to get the cue ball reasonably high.
One. Six. Eight.
Green, brown, blue needed.
Oh, that was a good shot.
11.
That could easily have gone wrong. As we hinted,
15.
Mark Williams looks like he's going to prevail. In the first kind of scrappy frame in the last couple of reds this match. No heroics in the blue. Don't blame him for that. 20. Two snookers required.
And it turned out that the last red was crucial. Murphy missed it along the cushion.
Mark Williams, 20.
And left it for Williams to pot enough balls to leave his opponent needing two snookers. Mark Williams pulls the frame back, but Sean Murphy still leads by 4 frames to 2.
Thank you, frame 7. Mark Williams to break.
Mark Williams illustrating what a cool and determined match player he is. After being swamped in the first 3 frames, He's won two of the last three. So although Murphy is 4-2 up, Williams is still very much in it.
Pick the bones out of that.
What a long red.
Oh,
dear, dear.
You'd think it was laser assisted.
Oh, that was a most unusual shot into the pack.
Eight.
White off the black cushion with a bit of almost run inside and spin round plumb on this red. This again.
Nine.
Definitely a big part of Sean Murphy's armoury. He doesn't dwell on the disappointment 16. Of losing the last frame. On with the job.
Murphy's long potting has been a big feature of his game this evening. He's made 8 of the 10 that he's attempted. And quite a few of them have led to 24. Frame-winning breaks, including the first frame when he made 133 from a long pot.
Yeah, he needs an angle on this black, really. Just about got one. Not an awful lot onto left corner. You see the angle. So a wee bit of work to do here. Red's covering one another somewhat. Table's playing lovely, so if he's playing for the red, the bottom one in the bunch, you can actually play this with a bit of confidence that you're not going to get a springy bounce off the second rail. He's deciding to settle for red to left middle. So a little mini test here, the first test.
42.
This contribution. One of the best in the game at this type of shot into the middle pocket. But no, sir. What damage has he done? Doesn't appear to have done any.
Sean Murphy, 42.
Well, again, relief for Williams that it wasn't more than 42 from Murphy. examining the possibility of a plant.
Maybe a chance of a double here for Sean into the right centre. It all depends if he can screw back and play for the black in the left corner. He'll definitely play it if he can do that. If he can't even get a double, he could actually play a treble. It's an unusual way of playing it. He's looking at the double.
Chance to go on to clinch the frame.
And that was a gorgeous piece of cueing.
Eight.
It didn't look much, but the grab that he got in that was exceptional.
Murphy certainly played okay this week, but this is altogether a higher level of performance from him.
Yeah, considering as well the level of performance by Mark Williams this week. All right, saying go out there and play the table.
16.
You're always aware the damage that your opponent can do coming in at your back.
17.
Bridging over the red is just a wee bit uncomfortable for him. Doesn't seem to make any difference to the reaction he's getting.
24.
Frame ball. Just coming up, this black.
25.
Not absolutely sure.
Very good stuff from Murphy.
33.
Who is intent on getting through to the final to play Ronnie O'Sullivan. We beat in the Champion of Champions final in Coventry in November. 10-8.
37.
And also played O'Sullivan in the UK final. That match was 5-5 before O'Sullivan ran away with it to win 10-5.
Forty-one.
The injuries, just about enough practice to come in this week, but they do say enough is as good as a feast.
Sean Murphy 45
from Sean Murphy in that frame. He goes 3-up with 4 to play with a 5-2 lead.
Thank you, frame 8. Sean Murphy to break.
Murphy intends to make this the last frame of the evening. much more emphasis there from Williams on the safety rather than the pot. May not have attempted the pot at all.
Half ball off the bunch. Push a few reds into play. Set mark. Another question to answer here. He's not falling for it. Cue ball down this end again. He left a little tempter. Red to right middle. Having a look here, if we can, the cue ball looks like it's going to go. Certainly not going to cannon the blue if he took it on. But probably goes on the line towards the yellow. So if he plays for green and gets high enough, the only red he could leave is the one he's attempting. Surprised he's not taking it on.
Perfect line and length from Williams.
Yeah. He's not going to play in behind the blue, I wouldn't think. Not from the bulk cushion, dropping that red dead weight. That'd be too risky. The trouble in playing the conventional safety off the outside red on the right-hand side is if he doesn't get near the bulk cushion, he's going to be dropped in behind the blue by mark. But he is playing it, so it's critical here that he gets a good cue ball. Yeah, much too thick.
So, the immaculate line and length from Williams forced Murphy into a mistake.
One.
6.
Yeah, the black obviously goes.
Seven.
No, I'll be over the moon with that shot. That opens everything up now.
14.
Not get this direct, but if you need be, we'll trace a side just to straighten it up. Shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, good shot. It gives a little chance to 15. See what Mark Williams has been working on technique-wise here. You watch him pre-shot routine. He tries to get himself set on the line of the shot he's hitting. Gets his head in the middle of his torso.
22.
In the line of the shot and trusts what his eyes are seeing and walks in and plays it. It's not something that he always has done. He worked very hard
23.
On it.
But that is the essence of the sight right method, which was pioneered by Stephen Feeney, former bank executive from Norwich, who now has an army of sight right coaches spreading the gospel.
28.
I see him when he walks back to get on the line of playing this black here. Stand back, get the head in the middle and the torso facing it. You see him just setting it again there.
37.
These 42. Seven reds in the open, well, they're not really in the open. I don't think any of them go, actually. It's a nice angle in this black. He's deliberately played low on it.
43.
Not quite got it. Just low of straight, if anything. To be playing for one of these reds, but no choice, so a big shot now.
50.
And it's awkward bridging as well for a lefty. He's getting himself set on this big shot. Stephen mentioned the studio.
58.
This season. 36th century's coming in. He's never put a lot of stock in making century breaks, as Mark, but it's quite a big 59. Tally for him. As I say, he doesn't concentrate on them, but he's definitely scoring a lot heavier these days.
In the past, more so than these days, he's very often missed deliberately on 70 or so once the frame is in the bag. So his career total would be a lot higher than 419, but for that.
There he is, setting himself again. At least this is a natural in between middle pocket and pink. Yeah, good shot. He's had to work hard for these, it's not been easy. Red's covering one another, but he's almost there. 64. Red, black will be enough.
What a cool and determined match player Mark Williams is.
72.
5-2 is a big deficit, but he trapped Murphy into a mistake with
73.
An immaculate safety shot early in this frame, and he's been at the table ever since.
There's also great economy in everything that he does out there, Mark Williams. No fancy cue action. Doesn't overhit any shot ever. Keeps it nice and simple.
How important is it, Alan, that Williams keeps Murphy in his chair 86. For another few minutes?
Well, yeah, if you were taking anything out of the Stephen Hendry book of snooker, then that's what Stephen always preached. Make the guy suffer for as long as you possibly can. Get him as cold as you can. I think it is important. Try and make a big 94. Ton. And it's 95. Good, this, isn't it, that he's actually trying to make a big ton. You know, as you say, in the past, he wouldn't be all that bothered, really. Frame's done, but he's taking great pride in his performance. And that also comes from the work that he's done in his game. Generous tap in the knee by Sean Murphy there as well.
100.
This has been excellent.
101.
Developing the pink in order to facilitate a total clearance.
100. Yeah, he now plays with this method that won't allow him to play shots willy-nilly. Every shot has to be given full concentration because of the technique.
109.
Not so much this one, but
not so much out of body, but under the body.
Yeah, great response.
One hundred and twenty-one.
He's laughing there because he forgot his technique and he landed nowhere. It still didn't make any difference. Great stuff by the big man.
And a double to finish. Not quite. But that was a superb break at 127. It keeps the match alive. But Williams still has it all to do because Murphy still leads by 5-3.
Thank you, frame 9. Mark Williams to break.
Not that many matches get won from 3 down with 4 to play. One that does spring to mind is Karen Wilson coming back from 5-2 deficit to beat Judd Trump 6-5 in the semi-final of the Masters. But it's a good lead and the player in front usually manages to hang on. Will this be an exception?
You're going back to that last frame. Remember that red that Sean had to right middle? He refused it. Not like him.
Foul and miss. Mark Williams, four.
Well, one thing at this standard, you have to seize victory. It's very rare that an opponent makes so many mistakes, he effectively gives it to you.
Yeah, you have to go out and grasp it, don't you? A bit like putting in golf. The hole won't come to the ball.
Nudged that a little bit more firmly than he wanted to. And once that had happened, I didn't expect Williams to miss it.
Just having a laugh there, that was good. Mark Williams trying to just nudge that in. I just wonder what would have happened if the red had dropped in. I actually think that, you know, there was nothing untoward there, but as I say, if the red had dropped in, I think the referee would have replaced it.
Yes, if after the shot has been completed, it drops through vibration, the ball is replaced. It was a very tough shot to dig the cue ball out of that corner, especially with the spider.
Brown ball. Sean Murphy won.
Cue ball so close to the bulk cushion there. Mark doesn't want to play off the left edge of the cluster. Pushing reds open, that's a high tower of safety. So he's done quite a few times tonight, just settle on the containing shot. Value in taking something on. Yeah. Left one of the two.
Could attempt that with no risk of leaving another red.
think Sean might be tempted to take this red on. Can either play it, spin it round three cushions for the black, which I think he probably will, because if he gets close to the pot, should he miss it, red should stay up there. No, decided to go deep on it. Has he done any damage? Definitely made the pot more difficult. He's just about gotten away with it.
Not out of three for long potting between them in this frame. Attempted the pot and would have had black ball position.
Yes, and these top players don't really like these frames, cue ball in the black cushion, pushing reds into open play. But he doesn't have an awful lot of choice in this. Taking the red on. Already could probably leave the one he's playing. Playing it to right middle.
Nothing left.
Yeah, it's one of those tables, isn't it, where it's almost impossible to play a telling safety shot. If I was shown here, the red in the bulk cushion, I'd be shoving that back down this end, because the two reds that are in the bulk side of the table towards the right side cushion, Mark would then play one of them. The theory is that the other one would then be left for Sean to play off by just looking ahead a few shots. I'm saying that, I don't think Mark Williams would fall into that, in fact I know he wouldn't, but it would certainly get the frame a more conventional look about it.
A good shot in that he's got the cue ball tight to the black cushion.
Yeah.
I think Williams may have checked that the brown was in fact the brown. Maybe he suffers from a touch of colour blindness. A few players, Peter Ebdon notably, have suffered in that way, and he was just making sure.
Yeah, the look. He's Mark's looking for a re-rack. Don't blame him. He didn't get any change out of Sean Murphy there, he just ignored it.
This one is touch.
Mark definitely looked at Sean, and that look on his face as if to say, shall we? Had enough of it, he's taken another one on.
It was the only one he could leave, but it goes past the blue, so he has left it.
6-1.
Yeah, good shot. Good choice of shot, that.
6.
By playing it, he was expecting the cue ball to hold around the pink spot somewhere. Good value in playing it that way. So this is now a decent chance beckoning. And like all the top players, exceptional at closing out matches. Sean. Just wants to grab this properly and get top side of the brown. Yeah, cued it well.
13.
And now he's in business.
Oh,
that was a good piece of cue. It was almost 18. Too good. He's landed just straight in the blue. Chings, what a piece of cue, and that was to hold it. I was thinking bulk colour more than blue, in all honesty. So he's not out of the woods yet.
Can only take the cue ball straight forward or straight back. I think there's very little you can do with regard to favouring one side of the pocket or the other.
Yeah, and he won't be playing the yellow with his hand on the table. He probably would if he didn't have a neck problem. But that would be too big a stretch, or rather too painful a stretch. He consider using the knuckle playing this, the top jaw. He did.
Foul. Sean Murphy, 18. Mark Williams, 5.
Well, desperately tried to retain position on his next red by using the top jaw of the middle pocket. But it was just too straight. Cool opening red from Williams, rolling it along the ball cushion.
Yeah, wiped his feet, but he's just this side of the balk line, so he'll be taking the yellow on. The red on the right side cushion's in his way. He wants to go two cushions and probably disturb something. Missed the red. Full ball kiss on this red, and he's perfect.
3.
Okay, not perfect, but as good as he could have expected.
attempted to screw clear of the
Mark
black,
Williams free.
But just
Sean
flicked
Murphy
it,
four.
Hence the in off. Hasn't left an opening red for Murphy though. Well, any return to the ball cushion has got to be perfect in view of the fact that there's a red in the middle of the table. Played that well, almost perfectly.
Safety wise, there's not an awful lot doing for Sean here. He may be tempted to play the red to right middle. If it's the only red he can leave, he'll probably play it. But can he figure out a way of playing it? It's just off straight the wrong way. Is actually a very clever shot indeed to put that red over the corner and cover it. It's one of the best shots Sean Murphy's played tonight.
Well played and well thought out.
Yeah, and no wonder Mark's leaning on the table thinking, by jings, what a shot that was. Very good stuff this from Sean. I think he's played a considered match tonight, all in. You see it, there was no attempt at the pot, he was just weld the cue ball to the right side cushion, he could virtually impossible to leave that red. I mentioned earlier that I thought Sean had the upper hand in the safety tonight, which would not have been the prediction before it, but it's definitely been the case. Chess games continue.
The plant of the two reds left of the pink isn't quite on unless very thin contact is made on the first red. He doesn't want to risk it.
He wouldn't maybe mind so much playing it if he felt he could get on a colour, but I don't think he can. At least if there was some reward at the end of it, he might feel better about playing it. I think he's just going to skinny off them. Or is he playing it? Oh, what a shot. Unfortunate.
Two.
Well, it took a long time to work himself up to play that. Two reds were potted, but crucially, he lost position.
There's only really one shot on here, is thin off the yellow. Almost play the pot in the green pocket and hope to get the cue ball somewhere around where it is at the moment. Can't see anything else on.
Blue ball.
He's not playing the cut in the middle, is he? He's coming round to look at it. Sets himself. Decision's made, he's going for it.
Well, he was nearer to fluking it than potting it. Very, very tough shot, and would only have played it if he could see no viable alternative whatsoever.
It's not perfect, not by a long stretch. Playing this with the rest, you know how good he is with it. No, what does he do? Is it, it's either dead weight or deep screw. He prefers playing deep screw shots with the rest, does Sean. Oh, that is a stunner. Where's the cue ball? Just all right.
11.
Twenty in front, two open reds, the other much more awkwardly situated.
Yeah, scoreboard check, 23.
16.
Need another 13. Off these two reds, which equates to a pink and a blue.
There's his pink. And his blue surely coming up.
23. 24.
Yes, yeah, so a miscalculation a second ago, but this blue should be enough to see Sean Murphy into tomorrow's final.
29.
38 the difference, only 35 on, but not taking anything for granted yet. It's only one snooker.
Yeah, he's trying to probably pot this red in the right-hand black pocket and get the snooker. That'll do nicely.
Sean Murphy, 29.
Williams has got to hit this.
Foul.
Instead, he miscues.
Sean Murphy, 4.
So that is it. A very fine match. Murphy played magnificently in taking a 3-0 lead. Rated 133, 70 clearance and 117. Williams fought hard. He won three of the next five frames, but could never win two in a row. So it is that Sean Murphy goes through to the final, the winner by 6-3.
England lineup for the Players' Championship trophy here in Llandudno tomorrow. Ronnie O'Sullivan will play Sean Murphy after Sean beat Mark Williams 6-3 here tonight in Venue Cymru. And he stepped in to join us now. Congratulations on a fine win there, Sean. You must be really, really pleased with the way you're playing. How's the neck? Because if that's you playing with an injury, they'll all be wanting one.
Yeah. Mark actually said at the interval, he said, I'll take a bad back if that's what happens. But, yeah, I mean, obviously it's very easy to say, oh, it was great, but it wasn't. You know, most shots were played in quite a lot of pain out there. It's sort of that twist to the left and bending over and then having to look back at it's that movement that's a killer. And, yeah, it was tough. But I think, in a funny kind of way, you know, coming here not in full fitness has sort of taken my mind off it a little bit. And, you know, certainly from an expectation point of view, you know, I certainly didn't expect to be in the final when I came here.
Interesting. I mean, obviously, just briefly, what Ronnie was saying earlier in the week about whether he's right or wrong about this, a lot of the players are burnt out, is what he said, if you heard him say that, and he may have a valid point. But you having 2 weeks off for this reason might have made you fresher. I know you've got a bad neck and back, but you've had 2 weeks without playing. You would have definitely gone to Gibraltar, you'd have gone to Romania, and you haven't practiced much, but you've done all the practice, and you look sharp.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it? It's amazing how you can try and sometimes do all the right things and get nowhere. And, you know, I literally haven't played at all since the Welsh Open and came here with zero expectations, but completely fresh.
Yeah.
You know, rested and not stressed, not with travelling, not trying to get from all over the place and getting here late and organising matches and things and just sort of, you know, for 2 weeks got ready to come here. And I think you'll just see now, you know, Ronnie's leading the way, really. Players will start to pick and choose much more tournaments now because it's unrealistic to be at the top of your form all the time. Yeah. And I think, you know, he's leading that charge and I think others will follow.
And in fairness, you were looking really comfortable tonight. You know, you played super snooker. I mean, you started really well. Mark came back at you, but even when he came back at you after the break, you seemed quite relaxed.
Yeah, well, although I haven't played at all, you know, I spent those 2 weeks doing a lot of studying. I studied the game quite in depth. I watched a lot of old footage of myself and other players trying to search because I've been struggling technically for the last few months. And I watched some old footage of some times where I was playing really well. And I noticed a couple of technical things. And so I made a note that when I came here and got my cue out, I would try it. And the technical change made a difference immediately.
What do you mean specifically?
Well, I mean, it's quite deep, but, you know, when you play with side spin, the cue ball doesn't travel in a straight line. And how much it turns is varied upon, like, where your grip is, how close your bridge is to the ball. All of that makes a difference, a bit like a golfer holding the club down or up the shaft. And slowly but surely, my grip has crept too far down the cue. I've also had half an inch taken off my cue, and I forgot to move my grip backwards. So it's a bit in-depth, but basically I'm holding the cue more at the end. and I'm getting the shape on the ball that I'm looking for.
I must admit, your technique looks pretty much the same as it's always done to me, and you've always hit the ball pretty well. So, I mean, there are people with worse techniques, but it's a question of tinkering with the odd little bit that sometimes only you can see, maybe.
Yeah, well, at the turn of the year, I made the decision to sort of take my game to pieces, and everyone around me went, this is a massive mistake. You know, I think you even said at some tournament before this, you know, it's a massive, massive risk. And perhaps those couple of weeks gave me a chance just to, do you know what, I've got to go back to basics here.
Yeah.
And I found something chatting with my, you know, my coach, Chris Henry. He said, oh, have you checked your grip distance? Have you checked your... And I thought, do you know, I will. And he was right.
Let's take a look at some of the shots then from the match. We'll start with the final frame here, Neil.
Yeah, I mean, look, you wanted to get over the line, but one thing, when you get the rest out, you're pretty reliable with that. You know, you're one of the best around with it, and that was a good shot. And then there was this shot, Stephen, we were looking at it, took a couple of shots, the pink that he potted. Could have missed.
This is a tough shot because to control the cue ball can easily end up down somewhere near the green pocket, can't it?
Well, it's one of those. The blue was an easier pot, but all I could see was snookering myself behind the black.
This is quite nice, isn't it, when your opponent.
Nice sound, isn't it? Nice sound when you're standing behind them.
That's a horrendous sound. Of course, we're all. There's a big thing. We're all using this new chalk, and well, not all. Some of us are. And, you know, the odd miscue extra is one of the small little concerns with it. They have brought out 2.0, which apparently cures all miscues as well. So you'll see a lot of that chalk being used in the future.
Yes, yeah, such an important part of the game. You know, we've talked more about chalk, I think, the last few months than ever before. Let's take a look at the start of the match then, because you came out so strongly. What a fantastic break to get you up and running.
I said in commentary, I think that's the first three frames is some of the best snooker I think I've ever seen you play. Your whole focus, everything, you look really up for it.
Yeah, I would agree, and I think that's the right word is focus. I think it's almost easier when you play one of the legends, you know, one of the real legends of the game, because you know going out...
You know what you've got to do.
It's a very simple equation. All parts of your game have got to be strong, and this was a good shot here to sort of, you know, get round, and this was a good steal of that frame.
Well, you drilled it in. I mean, you drilled the pinky, you drilled that... You know, browning, and then you know, rolled it in. Here's another one that was tight, actually, and moving the red away.
Yeah, that was, you know, I wasn't 100% sure whether that went. That was, I was hitting it, expecting the referee maybe to go foul, and he didn't, and it looked all right to me. So
I think it was okay.
And the fourth, you lost the fourth frame. You're a little bit careless position. You end up losing the fourth frame, so you weren't feeling good in the dressing room, obviously.
Isn't it a strange game, ours?
Because you played so well the first three.
If someone had said to me this afternoon, you're going to be 3-1 up at the interval, I'd have snapped their hand off against Mark. You know, I was absolutely raging in the interval upstairs. I must have been walking around with a real sour face. And 3-1 up, and I really had to give myself a talking to. You know, come on, you're 3-1 up here. But having lost the fourth frame, you know, you sort of think, how important will that be come the end of the match in an hour's time when everyone's twitching? You know, will that frame have been much more important? And
I guess it only becomes important if you dwell on it for too long, and that's when after 15 minutes...
Well, I dwelt on it for 15 minutes, that was enough.
Well, certainly, over the line, you enter tomorrow's final, another rematch, Ronnie O'Sullivan, you beat him in the Champion of Champions. Get your thoughts on this one?
Well, I just think, you know, we're playing in an era of greatness, and, you know, it's a real personal honour and challenge to go up against Ronnie in another final. You know, again, like I was just saying there, when you play a legend, when you play one of the greats, it's a very simple equation. Play your best or lose. So it's simple for me.
Well, it's one each, isn't it?
Yeah, UK final.
It's one each this year. You know, it's
the decider
it's
in
substantially
London.
Heavier the other way, I can tell you. But I'll be trying my best.
Well, you certainly look good today. Thank you very much indeed, Sean. Of course, Sean victorious against Mark Williams, but Mark has been talking to Phil Yates.
Mark, a disappointment, but Sean played very well.
I can't say I'm disappointed, to be honest. He played really well. I mean, he missed only a couple of balls. His long pot in, you know, he put some unbelievable long balls when I had him in tight on the cushion, and I think he won two or three frames from it. Safety was strong. You know, I stuck in there. I was a little bit unlucky on, you know, bits and pieces, especially the last frame. I've done a crazy plant, really, but I had no choice because it was a red on the all, and if I played safe, he'd have just rolled a red and knocked the other one in. So I've left myself probably one of the worst positions I've ever left myself in. I haven't had a go. It was either the black or the blue I've had to go for. And you know, I took the blue just because it was a red near the all, it could flick off there. But apart from little nudges here and there, I didn't play bad. He played, you know, excellent.
It was very early in the match, I know, but the second frame was pivotal. either side of that pink, you'd have been on a red, snookered yourself, and he made a good clearance in the end.
Yeah, there's always turning points in matches, but, you know, you can't look at it like that because the fourth frame, you know, he should have won the fourth frame and had done a good clearance to win it. You know, that's just the way it is. You win frames you shouldn't, and you lose frames you should win. You know, that's just the way it is. And, you know, if he keeps playing like that, he's got every chance of beating Ronnie in the final. I would have loved to have had a crack at Ronnie in the final, you know, but I want to be.
Overall, though, your performance here this week has been another confidence-building one. I thought your performance against Ryan Day in the quarterfinals was exceptional.
Yeah, I played. I can't say I didn't play very well there. He just shut me out. He done to me the first three frames. What I done to Ryan didn't look like missing. And some of the balls he was potting, I had him. The one safety shot I played, an excellent safety shot, got him right in the jaws of the middle. And he even said, great shot. It cost me the frame. He dropped the red in black and he had 100, I think. So, you know, wish he never said good shot, man.
But no player in the history of snooker has ever dusted themselves off and gone on with the next tournament quicker than you have. So you'll be down at that Championship League next week, looking to win that one.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to the Championship League, to be honest. But I'm not worried about defeats. You know, the worst thing that can happen tonight was Sean beat me and he beat me. That's it. That's the worst that can happen. Well, who cares?
And finally, you can answer this or not. Completely up to you. Prediction for the final?
Obviously, Ronnie's favourite, but Sean, if he can keep playing like that, he's got every chance. You know, whether or not he does is another thing, but if he does, he's got every chance. And I wish I could play like that with a bad back, that's for sure.
Overall, you're playing fantastic stuff, and long may it continue.
Thanks, cheers.
He is indeed. He's been fantastic all week. Nobody is going to want to play Mark Williams at the Crucible coming up. Now, obviously, Sean Murphy now into the final against Ronnie O'Sullivan. We saw Ronnie in action last night against Judd Trump. A tremendous match we had here in Venue Cumann. It went all the way to a deciding frame. Let's see it now.
Brilliant. Eight.
Black on spot. Lots of potable reds. Match winning chance for Trump.
Well, that's not a good shot.
Yeah.
Leapt up. As if I don't know whether you've got 16. A bad contact. It didn't sound suspicious. See it again. Oh, I don't know. The cue ball just didn't come back as he thought, and he's now got a really difficult shot of this red. It cuts in. The cue ball is not guaranteed to get onto a colour, and the pot is not hanging over the pocket either. So, see this slight worry coming. Would you believe it?
16.
One problem led to another there, Clive.
Well, it did. Trump couldn't have asked for a better match-winning chance than that. It went wrong very quickly.
Well, this is a real test of O'Sullivan's cueing. A slight angle on this to get in behind the black to play it into the same pocket. Oh yes, delightful. It was a test. He passed with flying colours.
Great cueing, great nerve.
Yes, he probably felt a few shots ago that he might not leave that seat other than to shake hands with Judd Trump, because it was a golden chance. Quite amazing he broke down as early as he did in the way that he did.
Trump also missed a golden chance early in the penultimate Eight. Frame.
Nine.
Once again, Ronnie O'Sullivan's cue ball control is not as it usually is.
Sixteen.
17.
Well, he couldn't ask for a better chance than this. And it was all because he queued in a beautiful long red. Check of the scores, 30. Plenty more needed, but maybe just sizing up which open reds he needs to take. Does he need to take anything that develops other reds? Those two reds close together,
31.
At the moment are just about out of play. But right now, getting 40 or 50 would seem like an awful lot in the context of a match like this. You get to a decider. 50 breaks like a century break at times.
37.
I think one of the reds, the right red, I think, goes to the right middle if he gets the cue ball in the perfect place.
38.
Yes, and that's where he's at with this shot, because he's very straight on the black. 38. Can't cannon them from there.
39.
Instead playing on the other two reds. It's all about the percentages, I suppose.
45.
Again, looking at the scores. Only 32 in front, with still 67 available, so not home by any means.
46.
Two reds developed into much more favourable positions.
Yes, and that all means that this pink, if he plays it, is a very big shot. If he played the blue, the pot's easier, but position is quite difficult. So if he plays the pink, it's the biggest shot of the match so far.
48.
He didn't just roll it in, he played it with authority. A tremendous shot.
52.
There's nothing wrong with O'Sullivan's bottle under pressure.
53.
Yes, and this pink and one more red, and he's won a match that I can honestly say many times during his career I think he would have lost. Playing like a man, he's won four ranking tournaments this season already, with power to add.
59. 60.
This match has shown modern snooker at its very finest. There have been three centuries, two by Trump, one by O'Sullivan. Great break making. Great shot making.
67.
The most subtle of tactical play at times. High drama.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 67.
And it has all ended, barring something truly remarkable, in a 6-5 win for O'Sullivan. Trump will know that he's had match-winning chances, one in the penultimate frame at the start of it, when the balls were well spread. And also early in this frame. But he just wasn't able to seize the golden moment. This is a very wide ball to hit, this red near the yellow pocket. There's no room round it, so it'll be amazing if O'Sullivan concedes any penalty points here. Trump fights on, but
well,
I think we can only say of him, tell me how long the train's been gone.
Eight.
Six the difference, only 35 remaining. And it needs to be a very good snooker to force O'Sullivan to concede the necessary penalty points. Sullivan is the current people's favourite. Maybe that status will pass to Trump. I don't think O'Sullivan would mind if it did. But for the moment, O'Sullivan remains the man. Trump must be awfully disappointed.
What?
It did look this week that he'd regained top form after a rocky patch.
Ronnie O'Sullivan won.
But he hasn't been able to turn it into a win he desperately wanted. Ronnie O'Sullivan beats Judd Trump by 6-5. And he goes through to Sunday's final.
Can't wait. It's going to be an absolutely cracking final, a belter. We saw them, of course, play in the Champion of Champions final, where Sean Murphy was victorious. And then, of course, the UK and York, where it was Ronnie got his own back. So, Llandudno, the decider.
Yeah, and he played brilliantly in that UK final. It was 5-5, and then Ronnie moved up a gear to beat him, you know, and look, they're very different personalities, aren't they? Let's be honest about it. They couldn't be more different, and it kind of adds to the spice. There's rivals, but not. There's nothing like. There's not really any needle there. They just don't really, wouldn't really go out for a drink with each other, I think, you know, very different people. So I think that adds a little bit to it. Ronnie will start favourite because Ronnie's just beating everybody, and Sean's already been in 4 finals this season. This is 5th. So it's the same old faces all the time, you know. Me and Mark was there, and Sean, it's just the same old faces. John Higgins has won a couple.
Yep. It's interesting. The final, the last final we watched against Ding Junhui missed a trick in the afternoon. Ronnie started quite slow in that match. He started slow a few matches this week as well. Also in the UK final with Sean Murphy, 5-5, then he pulled away. So Sean Murphy really needs to really knuckle down the first 3 frames tonight. If he can do that tomorrow afternoon session, and really try and get a lead. If it's anywhere close, the evening session, Ronnie sort of just seems to. The evening sessions of finals, it just seems to find something, that gear that Neil was talking about.
Yeah, it's best of 19, the final here. As you say, we've seen him twice this week, Ronnie allow his opponent to take a lead, and then he's just steamrolled them.
You don't want to do that against Sean because, trust me, when he lost to Sean in the Champions final, he was bitterly disappointed, which is understandable, you know. I mean, it was important. It looked like going 9-all, you know, and Ronnie was sick there. He spoke well afterwards, and then he went off to Shanghai the next morning and just demolished everyone and won that event. But I couldn't wait, you know, to see it. It's going to be a great, great final.
There's very few players in the game now that I think Ronnie thinks can beat him, let's be honest. Yeah. I think he thinks that Sean can, and I think he's got respect for Sean as a player. John Higgins is certainly one. Selby, when he plays, is certainly one. But there's very few. But Sean is definitely one of them.
You've got to wonder who's going to be in the Champion of Champions this year, because, as you say, Ryan Day, John Higgins,
Ronnie, and
Mark Williams have kind of sewn it all up this year. Michael Giorgio will be there.
Michael Giorgio should be there. Yeah, you know, and Neil Robertson is going to be there as well. There are other players involved, but not that many, because the same faces keep winning, and it's the older players, the 40-somethings, are doing well.
And of course, Stephen, Ronnie has that added carrot this week of, if he can win here, that's 5 ranking titles this season.
Tremendous achievement. Everyone keeps saying, no one player can dominate anymore, but certainly his domination, it's starting to be domination of the game.
Yes.
He has hinted there might be a bit of a bonus in it for him as well.
Well, maybe so. I mean, I don't know about all that, but what he's doing is wonderful, I think, and he looks after himself so well. He deserves everything he gets. He works very, very hard.
It's going to be an absolutely cracking final, isn't it, tomorrow here in Venue Cymru. We are back at 12:45 for the start of this one. As I said, best of 19. Ronnie O'Sullivan up against Sean Murphy, who will be crowned this year's Champion of Champion. And of course, we'll be back in the evening to bring it to a conclusion. My thanks to the guys. We will see you tomorrow, 12:45. Bye for now.